I'm Jeremy Ford. In this lesson, I'm going to be painting wet in wet. What do we mean by wet in wet? Let me show you. Small amount of water, and I'll mix some watery paint, some very thin watery paint, just with one colour for now. Wash the brush thoroughly, and I'll wet a small area of the paper with clean water. So all wet in wet is wet paint on wet paper. Here's the watery paint, and if I just drop that on, you'll see the paint explode. Add a little bit more water to it so it's a bit wetter still. You can spread it out with more water. And you can get some quite interesting shapes and patterns. If you want to control the paint a little more than that, then you need slightly drier paint. That means paint without quite so much water. So this is a slightly thicker consistency. And then that's still wet in wet, but it's not as wet. And you can make some more distinct shapes. And this won't run as much as those, because there isn't the same amount of water. It's the water that spreads out the paint. Now this can be very useful for indistinct background colours, or you might want slightly soft-edged, slightly out-of-focus background shapes, such as leaves or stems. Now this needs to be done fairly quickly while your paper is wet. I think that once the shine has gone from the paper, it's a little bit dangerous to put watery paint on. Otherwise, it can have started to dry. I'll show you what I mean in a minute, when this is a little bit drier. There's still a shine on the paper, so I can still put some more paint on. So this is just a little bit gentler than the hard-edged wet on dry. You can see the difference between the two. Now if I put some watery paint into where it's drying, sometimes you can get a very strange shape, like a cauliflower or blooming. And that happens when wet paint meets drying paint. And if you're not quick, the paper can have started to dry before you get the paint on. So you need to see the shine on the paper to make sure it's going to work. You can just see here where the paint was too watery. That's caused a cauliflower or blooming. The paint was far too wet and it met the drying paint and it's formed this edge here. So you need to get the consistency of the paint just right. Try paints of different consistencies, different strengths, and see how the paint reacts. You're not trying to make any definite shapes, but just see how the paint behaves on the paper. Now let's put that wet in wet into practice. And I'm going to do that by adding a third colour, and this is a wonderful red called Permanent Rose. It's a super colour, particularly for flowers. When it's applied thinly, it's a beautiful pink, and when it's applied thickly, it's a deep, deep cherry red. And we can mix a lot of other colours from the red and the blue. We can mix violets, and from the red and the yellow, that will give us a big range of oranges as well. Well, I'm going to paint a couple of poppies using the wet in wet method. So I'll take a small amount of the red, and then in another well, I'll take some more red, but add yellow to this, the cadmium yellow, and that will give us a nice orange. Just a little bit wetter. So that's the red on its own, and that's the red with the yellow. Now using a clean brush, wash the brush thoroughly, wet the paper as we did before, nice and wet. It's surprising how quick paper dries, so get plenty of water on. If you're doing this at home and the doorbell goes, ignore it. Right, in with the pink. And the poppy shape is a little bit like a squashed eight, figure eight. And then the other one, the oranger one with a little bit of yellow added. While that's damp, I'll drop a little bit of blue and red mixed together right into the middle. Not too wet. If it's too wet, remember you get that cauliflowering. The wetter it is, the more it spreads out. If you don't want it to spread out like that, while it's damp, just mop it up with your brush. I don't mind it, I think it's quite nice. And then to finish those off, I'll put a little stem underneath them with some blue and yellow mixed together. And there we are. Okay, let's put everything that we've learned so far into one picture. Wet in wet and wet on dry. I'll start off by drawing a couple of simple poppy shapes. Similar shapes that we put on the wet in wet picture, but of course I didn't draw those. And I'm going to wet the background and drop the colour in. So we'll start off by mixing some colours for the background, some greens using the yellow and the blue, yellow green and a bluer green. And I can deaden that green by adding a tiny amount of red to it, too much and it goes brown. Just a little bit of red will calm the green down. And I want some more poppy colours to drop into the background. A little bit more red and a touch of yellow. Wash the brush thoroughly and wet the paper, but not where the poppies are. So I'm going to wet just around the poppies. As carefully as you can. It's not easy to see where the water is, but if you can see the light shining on the paper, that helps. Nice and wet. So in with the yellow green, or the green that's got plenty of yellow in it. And just let it run, just let it burst into the background. Don't have to make any specific shapes, just blobs of colour. It's like an explosion of colour. And some of the darker green, little bits, and just let it all run. Spread it out a bit. Wash the brush and now pick up some of the strong red and drop that into the background. This is going to be a background poppy. Carefully up to the edge of the poppy I drew. Perhaps put another one on the other side. Strong, powerful colour. Maybe something in the middle. Let that dry. There's a little mark here where the paint hasn't dried evenly. Sometimes when you do this wet in wet, It doesn't always dry perfectly evenly, but we can cover that up with grasses in the background or more flowers. So I'm going to put a really powerful red poppy right over where that little mark is. So that's plenty of paint and not very much water. So the paint's quite thick. That's using mostly red with a small amount of the yellow. I'll darken the lower part of that poppy just by adding a tiny amount of blue to it. And then while that's damp, drop in a little bit of blue and red mixed together, mostly blue.